Good morning, children. Welcome to English class. Do you like stories? Yes, of course, everybody likes stories. Today, we are going to learn an interesting story. This is the story. This is a funny story about two friends. Okay, so shall we read the chapter, children? Yeah, the story is about foolishness of Prakash and Prasanna, the two friends, okay, who put up placards to show the world, to tell the world at what they actually wanted to hide from everyone. Okay, so this is a funny story, okay, about the foolishness of two friends. Take your textbook, children. Take your textbook, term 2A. Take page number 6. The chapter heading is Honesty. H-O-N-E-S-T-Y. It is pronounced as Honesty. Okay. H is silent there. Honesty. Take page number 6. We'll read the story. Prakash lived in a village near Agra. He was an honest man. Okay, H-O-N-E-S-T, honest, honest man. One day, he found a gold ring on the road. He looked around and shouted loudly, "Whose gold ring is this?" Now, this ring had fallen off from a rich merchant's finger. Merchant, one who does business and all. Okay, this man is a very rich man. Fortunately, the rich merchant was nearby and heard Prakash shout. Fortunately means luckily. Okay, he was nearby. He checked his finger and lo, his ring was missing. Lo, lo means it's a word expressing surprise or calling an attention. Okay, it's just an expression word. He quickly walked up to Prakash and looked at the ring. Okay. "Oh my," the merchant thought, "this is my ring." So he took it up from Prakash and put it on his finger. The rich merchant was so impressed with Prakash's honesty that he gave him 15 silver coins. Impressed, impressed. I-M-P-R-E-S-S-E-D. Impressed means admired, liked. Okay. So this rich merchant liked Prakash honesty and he gave him 15 silver coins. Prakash had never seen so many silver coins before. He was very happy. At the same time, he was scared that someone might steal the silver coins. So Prakash had never seen such coins before. So he thought that somebody might steal it from me. He thought he would keep them with a friend. But he realized that that would not be safe. Then he thought that he would put them in a purse and carry the purse with him wherever he went. But he realized that that too would be unsafe. Okay, now he is very worried about what to do with the money. First he had so many thoughts. First he thought he would carry it with him always. So then he thought, oh, it would be unsafe. Suddenly an idea struck him. Struck, S-T-R-U-C-K, struck. Struck means he got an idea. Okay. He would hide the coins in his little garden. So, he dug a hole in his garden and hid the coins in it. Dug. Dug means he made a hole in his garden and hid. H-I-D, hid means to hide. It is the past tense of hide. Okay. Hid the coins in it. He covered the coins with fresh mud. But still he was not at ease. not at ease means she was not relaxed, she was not confident. Now also, will something happen to the coin? She was always worried. He thought, what if someone comes into my garden and takes away the coins? He could not sleep the whole night. The thought of the coins being stolen nagged him. So he had sleepless nights. He was worried about the coins. Okay. He thought and thought, and an idea struck him. Again, he had another idea. He went to the market and bought a brush and some paint. Okay. With the paint and the brush, he wrote the following words on a placard. No money is hidden here. And put the placard near the hole where he had hidden the silver coins. Placard. P-L-A-C-A-R-D. Placard. Have you seen placards? Yes. There will be a handle and there will be a board. Okay. And so you can write something on it. Okay. Look at this. This is a placard. We can hold it like this. Okay. So what did Prakash write? No money is hidden here. And he put this over the mud. Okay. Where he dug the hole in the garden. He placed the placard near the hole where he had hidden the silver coins. Some days later, Prasanna, Prakash's friend, came to visit him. He found the door locked and decided to have a stroll in the garden till Prakash came back. Stroll. Stroll means to walk. S-T-R-O-L-L. Just walking for relaxation. Okay, just walking in the garden till Prakash came back. So Prasanna, his friend, came to visit Prakash. So as Prakash was not at home, what did Prasanna think? Ah, let him come back. I walk in the garden. There, he saw the writing on the placard. He was surprised. What is this Prakash right here? He was thinking. He wondered why Prakash had written these words. Soon, he knew the reason. He sat down and began to dig the mud. The mud was loose and soft. He dug out the fresh mud and pushed his hands into the hole. Okay, the mud was just dug by Prakash, no? So it was fresh mud. As he did this, his hands touched something hard and cold. He had found the coins. He took the coins and put them in his pockets. He wanted to run home, but realized that someone might find out that he had stolen the coins. So, Prasanna took the coins. Now he wanted to run away from there. But just then he thought, if somebody had seen me taking these coins, then police will come, isn't it? They will catch me. He wanted to run home, but realized that someone might find out that he had stolen the coins. The police would catch him and put him in jail. He began to feel anxious and scared. Anxious means worried. A-N-X-I-O-U-S. Anxious. Okay, he was worried and scared. Now he is afraid. Prasanna began to think. An idea flashed in his mind. Flash means came into his mind. He took the brush and paint that Prakash had left in the garden and wrote something on a piece of paper and pasted it on the placard. So a placard was made by Prakash, isn't it? So on that he wrote something and pasted. What did he write? This is what he wrote. I have not stolen any money from the hole in the garden, as I am an honest man. And he wrote his name also. So this is what he wrote. I have not stolen anything. Okay, I haven't stolen any money from this hall because I am an honest man. And he wrote his name also there. What a foolish thing to do, isn't it, children? So both friends were foolish. The other one, Prakash, was honest, and due to his honesty, he did this foolishness. And this Prasanna, he was a dishonest man. Is it correct to take somebody's money? No, it's wrong, isn't it? So, Prakash and Prasanna both were foolish. One was honest, the other was dishonest. Children, can you tell the end of the story? What might have happened when Prakash came back from, he went somewhere, no? When Prakash came back, he found that his money is missing. What might have happened? This is an assignment for you. In not more than 10 sentences, you should write what might have happened. What is the end of the story? Okay, it's up to your creativity. You should write it. Take a rough book and write. Think what might have happened when Prakash came back. Okay, so what is the moral of the story? You should think before you do anything. And do not resort to dishonesty. Resort to means don't turn to the way of dishonesty. Don't adopt dishonesty in any means. You should not be dishonest. Always be honest. Okay. And think twice before you do something. That is the moral of this story. Did you all understand the story? Did you all enjoy it? Okay. Do the assignment. Write in 10 sentences. What is the end of the story in your rough book? Okay. So read the textbook 3 times. Okay, and underline all the new words and write and study the words. Okay, children. Thank you. See you in the next class.